I'm not much one for IDEs, but then I saw this guy. He's a competitive programmer, absolutely shredding a Facebook problem set, and he's using Sublime Text. Now, despite the frenzy of pop-ups, he's actually typing out most things fully, but every now and again, he does exercise an editor-provided completion. And Sublime Text pop-ups and on-the-fly linting are totally keeping up with him, which is more than I can say for Emacs, which, let's be honest, could not. You'll notice, however, he's got Emacs in his taskbar, so he's not a complete savage. I mean, he's savage for sure in the coding game, but he, being a manifestly fast thinker, appears to have made room in his life for a thinking man's editor. So this impressive display convinced me that Emacs must play the IDE game to be taken seriously. If we had the slightest chance of getting this guy or badasses like him to live stream with Emacs, we've got to try. Now, we followed the README and activated XLSP as a globalized minor mode. Now, suppose we open xfunctions.c from the Emacs source. For instance, we know we want to draw a UTF-8 string, but we can't remember the exact camel case spelling of the xlib function. So we type xutf8, then control meta I. Ah, there it is, xutf8 draw string. Now, a noob can't be faulted for following the very explicit but very ill-advised instructions to, and I quote, click on completion to select it. So that's what we're going to do for argument's sake. Sure, it worked as advertised, filling in the completion, but it was a super non-ergonomic way of doing it. Let's try again the right way. We type xutf8, then control meta I. Now don't lift your hands from the keyboard. We want xutf8 draw, so we disambiguate by typing a capital D. Then we hit tab. Emacs then completes as much as it can until it hits another fork in the road. Then we hit tab again. We type capital S to further disambiguate. Then we hit tab, and then we hit tab again, and it says sole completion, which means that it cannot do any better than this. Now, some of you think, gosh, it'd be faster to get the whole completion in one fell swoop by picking from a menu. It's hard for my old American brain to think that could be the case, but young guys from China are big on anything that emulates VS Code's colorful menu pop-ups that we saw in the earlier video. Not one to deprive the proletariat of what they want, XLSP is compatible with company mode, which provides for such eye candy. Here, we'll turn on company mode, and we'll get the colorful, icon-laden pop-ups that the kids know and love. Until I wrote XLSP, I've relied on Jaktasia's unreasonably effective dumb jump package. I mean, for something that so loudly professed its lack of sophistication, it was always impressive when it locked onto the right answer. With LSP, though, we no longer need to manually select among dumb jumps candidates. Here's what happens when I dumb jump to frame display info. I get a listing of possible jump points. Here's what happens when I straight up metadot in XLSP mode. It goes to the correct definition without any further ado. Now, the protocol allows for indentation, so, for instance, if we manage to screw up the indentation of this line in C code, we can call XLSP format region to restore it. Calling XLSP format region, however, is a profligately rich man's way of restoring the indent by doing a round-trip query and response with LSP. Any syntactic task like indentation or syntax highlighting really ought to be delegated to TreeSitter or the long-enduring Emacs parser. Now, just in time for election day in my home country, I'd like to discuss why XLSP should get your vote. Granted, XLSP is buggy, unproven, and hasn't implemented a fraction of the features its longer-lived counterparts, like e.g. LOT and LSP mode have. But it's young, scrappy, and gets to the point. If you're a Democrat, it's Beto O'Rourke. If you're a Republican, it's Josh Hawley. It's also a neat freak. I never latched onto the existing LSP packages because I was distrustful about their process cleanup. XLSP keeps a tight ship, killing server processes when they're no longer needed. So for instance, I meta-x list processes. I know at least xterm.h and xfunctions.c are client buffers of this clangd server process. Now, suppose I were to kill xfunctions.c, that would still leave xterm.h, and my list processes refresh indicates that, yes, cld still needs to run. Now suppose I were to kill xterm.h. Now there are no more source files for this project, and now cld should quietly kill itself. I'll refresh the process list, and I'll note that, in fact, XLSP cleaned up after itself. Then there are the numeric constants. So in EGLOT, comparisons are made against actual hard-coded numerals, like this numeral 1. Contrast that with XLSP, which encodes all those numerals into semantic variables. And note, these variables were not manually def-const in the ELISP code. They're all automatically and dynamically generated from the Microsoft LSP specification. On to message construction. So the LSP protocol specifies messages as these hierarchical types. They're translated into TypeScript. EGLOT encodes these deep nested objects as shallow property lists, which is fine, except if you miss camel case a field or you manage to misspell a field, you'll only catch those errors at runtime because property lists have no compile time knowledge of what the specification looks like. Contrast that with XLSP, which does an automatic translation of this protocol into bona fide def structs. And so every time you make a message, you'll get LDOC help for one thing. And these structs can be arbitrarily nested. So the range field is itself a nested object, and you'll get LDOC help for that. The key thing, of course, is compile time checking. So if I emit the hyphen in the field and I attempt to compile the program, it will fail, because it has compile time knowledge of what these messages look like. I restore the hyphen and all is well. And these struct and method names tend to get long-winded, like my talk. So auto-completion is really helpful in this context. So there you go.